Perfect night because you deserve nothing less than you.
Oh, technology.
Hey everyone, I'm Eleanor and I'll keep this short and I promise there's an embarrassing story to come, so stay tuned. I first met Andrea in Year 7 when her curly fringe honoured us with its presence along with Andrea. Not only did I gain a lifelong friend since then, but another distant relative. That's right, we're actually fourth and fifth cousins, so we're about now. Now let's be honest, there isn't much you can't like about Andrea. We managed to get through high school with no real drama, and I think this is definitely a testament to her personality. Andrea is kind and caring and very trustworthy. She was always keen to listen to any issues and offer her Andrea advice, and most importantly, she put up with my imitations of her. Looking back, some of my fondest high school memories were the time we spent in biology and psychology. That's right, she did science subjects at school. I couldn't have asked for a better dissecting buddy. Only Andrea was careful enough to ensure the handles of the scalpels and scissors weren't contaminated with blood and to disinfect everything adequately. Our work ethic was flawless when motivated by food, and we often spent most of the time trying to get our track reports to fit onto a good number of pages than we did writing them. Equally as exciting were our psych classes. Ironically, I could count on Andrea to work out what colour pens to use, which were subheadings, main headings, sub-subheadings, what should be written in blue or black pen, whether the dot point list should be indented or normal. There's no one else I would rather summarise a textbook with than Andrea. I've only done it twice, and that was in Year 11 and 12 psych, and I think we took rote learning to an extreme. Now, a show of hands, who was at Andrea's 19th birthday at track?
Oh, yeah. I remember it, though.
Without going into a lot of detail, 10 points to Andrea for actually getting in. There was no official wager made on the night, but the general consensus was that we'd probably be having an early one. Sure enough, I remember at one point Andrea being circled by at least 5 or 6 of the boys, trying to escort her to the closest seating, away from security. Yota and I spotted Andrea at the Andrea huddle and quickly made our way by to their side to assist. We made it a fair way through the club, and when a lovely, tall, friendly security guard handed Andrea a bottle of water and politely informed us that she would have to be removed from the premises. Yota and Peter were happy to leave with Andrea and were escorted to the back exit, while she sent me back in to look for Jonathan to let him know we're leaving. I'd just like to thank the kind security staff for actually letting us back in, because as we know, there's no passouts at track. So we met up with Andrea and Yota and Peter at Church Street Maccas, where all good nights end. We were told to wait. She fell asleep in the car pretty much after we tried to sober up with some McNuggets and cups of water, while we literally kicked it on the curb waiting for it to wake up from a nap. Now, let's be honest, Andrea hasn't done too many silly things, and we never let her forget that one. So, Andrea, I'd like to wish you a very happy 21st birthday. Have a wonderful night, and may the year ahead bring you good luck, love, and happiness, and be the beginning of only good things to come in the future. I love you like a female brother from another mother. And because I know that you expect no less to me, I just want to say, Andronikina Taikatos, this is great everything is. Can you call the other melon? May the mind of the his men, guess what from a caliente his sword. So this is Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
And just to translate, that was happy birthday, Andrea. Yes, I know. Okay, next up we're going to have Andrea's boyfriend,
first of all, I'm not used to hear myself. Again, first of all, let's start off with saying how stunned she looks now.
Yeah, boy.
Bad boy.
First of all, I was actually going to wing it tonight, but apparently this speech just came out of thin air and I just whipped a couple words together. Now, I'm going to begin with a few words to describe Andrea. She's cheerful, fun, sensational, wise, breathtaking, respectful, genuine, stunning, patient.
Annoying.
And sorry, Andrew, I can't actually understand your handwriting.